Okay, please be ready. We just start in 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Before to start the class, I want to make a simple dynamic. Can you please, Dani, welcome to your English class. And Belen, thank you. Welcome, Belen. Can you please, ladies, turn on your audios? I'm going to give you 30 seconds to speak in English. Any topic, whatever you want to speak about, is okay for me. 30 seconds. Ya, vamos, go.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
I'm okay, and you?
I'm fine. What are you? No.
How was your day?
Was boring because I don't do anything, and you?
Well, my day was normal because I do as I always do.
Okay.
How are you in at school? I don't know if the question is right, teacher.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Okay. But Belen, are you studying at a school or at the university?
In a school.
Ah, okay. Yes. How was your school today?
Well, today I don't have any class because the teachers tenían una reunión. What do you say?
The teacher had a meeting.
The teacher had a meeting. So today I don't do anything.
Okay.
Well, my class day was boring, and I sleep in one class.
Which one?
It was computation.
Computer, yes. Class.
Computer class. Because, okay. I don't know. I don't like anything about computer or something like that.
No, maybe the problem is it is totally opposite with virtual computer class to presentation.
Yeah, because
computer
we
class,
don't
right?
do nothing.
Anything.
We just
yeah.
watch the class. That's.
Yes, it's boring. Yeah. Yes, I totally agree with you. Okay, thank you so much, ladies. Okay, let's continue. Franklin, turn on your audio. Sofia Campos, turn on your audio. Okay, 30 seconds. Hey, recuerden, cuando alguien me hace una pregunta a mí, no me, o sea, la contesto, chivo, vea. Pero usted puede hacer otra pregunta. O sea, no se queda así como que, vaya, ¿y ahora qué más me vas a preguntar? O sea, regresémonos las preguntas. O en ese caso, le hace la misma pregunta o usted inventa una nueva. Franklin, inicio contigo. Franklin, se escucha una gran bulla ahí.
¿Mm?
Se escucha una gran bulla ahí en tu casa. ¿Cómo? Sí, ya no. Hoy sí, no, ya no.
Bye.
Ok, Franklin, Sophie, 30 seconds. Okay. Go.
Hello, Franklin. What's
Hi, Sophie. Excuse me?
What's going on today? You have classes. Do you have classes?
Yes, I have English class.
In the morning?
Language class.
Okay. Do you like?
Uh-huh. And you?
Yes, me too. In the morning? I have the first class, I don't remember, but I think is history. I like, it's important now because in the world have a lot of successes, teacher.
Success.
Success, and it's important that
include
now that you think it's important history.
Yes, Franklin, do you think History class is important?
Yes, it's important because the history class to solve histories.
Yes, it's about history.
It's about history, and how do you say te habla sobre historia?
It's about, it's about, can you please repeat it?
How do you say se habla de la historia de antes?
It's about our past. It's about our past.
Our past. Yes.
And I saw
equation?
Your, I saw your status, and I saw that you love the motorcycle. Why do you love the motorcycle?
Yes, why do you love motorcycles, Franklin?
Can you repeat, please?
Why do you love the motorcycle? You enjoy.
No sé a qué se refiere.
Hijo, porque amas las motocicletas. Ay, Franklin. Porque amas las motorcycles. My goodness. Why do you love motorcycles? Sophie, quizás hablar un poquito más despacio. Tú también, hija, porque como que te van siguiendo, mi amor.
Mira, yo no sé por qué hablo en español y en inglés.
Vaya, why do you love motorcycles?
For the adrenaline. And in my opinion, driving motorcycle is funny.
It's fun, okay.
I
question
love
for Sophie. Solo la Sophie te ha preguntado, vos no le has preguntado nada.
Sophie, do you like language class?
Yes, so because depends of the teacher, and I think it's important the teacher teach your class enjoy or kind
different dynamics.
Yes,
my opinion is I don't like, in my opinion is foreign because I don't understand anything.
Sophie, who is your language teacher?
Miss Mabel.
Yeah, she's nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
She trained us that kids. She is, I don't know, it's amazing.
Yeah, she's very nice. She's a good teacher.
Yes.
It depends of the teacher.
For example, if you are a mathematics teacher, you cannot be funny all the time because you are teaching math. So
yes,
some of the time
I love mathematics.
Really?
Yes.
Why?
My teacher is a cool person.
Okay, nice.
And explains very cool.
No, my God, I don't like mathematics.
I
remember
have a good teacher this year.
Who's your mathematics?
I love.
Who's your math teacher? Joaquin. Ah, yes. Is Gabriela's husband?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Well, in my case, I remember when I was studying at the school. Wow, I didn't like mathematics. I prefer language classes or science classes. Okay, chicos, thank you so much. Next, I'm going to continue. Let's see. Okay, me siento como la Katie cuando pasan los panaderos enfrente de la casa de ella. Okay, vamos con el Eric y Nati. Please turn on your audio. Okay, Vale y Nati.
Okay.
30 seconds, 30 segundos, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1.
Hi. Hi, Vale.
Hi, how are you?
Fine, and you?
I'm fine, with a little sleep.
Oh, yes, the weather don't help.
How is your day? Is
maybe it's a very interesting day because first I woke up early and in the afternoon I saw the play of soccer. I don't know if you like soccer.
No, no.
Well, I saw the match between Real Madrid and Chelsea, and I'm so happy for the results because I'm Barcelona, Chelsea.
Ah, okay.
And he passed at the finals to Champions League, and Real Madrid not.
Well, in my case, I don't like soccer. I don't know why, but no, I don't like soccer.
Me too.
Yeah. Okay, continue.
Okay.
What's your favorite sport? I don't know, basketball, tennis, softball.
Well, if I have, I don't have a favorite sport, but if I say one, maybe, can be soccer. Well, I can play this because I have a lesions in my legs and it's difficult. Okay.
Really, Vale, do you have a lesion?
And now you only.
Yes.
And now what you happened, only play for fun.
Excuse me, Nati.
Dele, dele.
I interrupt. Yeah, Valeria, I'm asking, what happened then?
Well, in my legs.
Ago,
and
1 year ago.
If I. When I was in
high school?
Eighth grade.
Okay.
My knee? I have a lesion too. And I can play in soccer because if it's hard.
Ah, okay. But do you have a surgery?
I don't understand.
Surgery? Cirugía, yes. You have a surgery?
No. If a lesions and they say it is a estiramiento de ligamentos.
Ah, okay. The ligament is tail. Ah, okay. Okay, continue. Yeah.
So I guess when the weather is cold, you have pain in your legs,
uh-huh,
or not?
That's a good question.
Vale?
Yes, Vale. if you don't understand the question, say, teacher, I don't understand. Be honest. Don't worry about it. Okay.
Okay.
So can you please, Nati, repeat the question again?
Okay. So I guess if the weather is cold, you have pain in your legs or not?
No. Now, in this moment, no.
It doesn't matter the weather. If it's hot, warm,
yes,
sunny day, cold, that doesn't matter.
That's gonna happen when you play soccer.
Well,
only happen just when you play.
Because of the weather and is right early and well yesterday I have a pain and and now it's complete different.
Okay, now you feel okay now?
Yeah.
So. Okay. Nati, do you have any lesion on your body or any surgery?
No.
Okay.
Surgery maybe, because when I was child, I have a surgery from my amygdala. I don't know how can I say that in English.
Sore throat.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I don't have sore throat.
Oh my God, because, really?
Yeah.
So
when I'm 13 years old.
It is true that when people don't have sore throat, they cannot sing?
No, no, maybe. Because when I want to sing in a little high level, mm-hmm. I can't because my throat hurt.
Okay.
But with the low level, mm-hmm. I can't.
So, for example, if you want to be a professional singer, you cannot.
Like Christina Aguilera, no.
Like Kinsley, yes.
Like Andrea Bocelli, maybe. Because
okay.
Your voice changes. It's low.
Yeah, okay.
The level is low. Huh?
Okay, Yulisa Ventura, no. Okay, no. Thank you so much. Okay, ladies, nice. The last couple, no voy a hacer it. Okay, let's see. Karina, welcome. Turn on your audio, please. And Harris.
Hi.
Okay, welcome. Okay. The same dynamic, 30 seconds.
Five. We have to talk about
any topic.
Any topic, okay.
Yeah. Harris, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, nice. 5, 4, 3, 2, action.
Hi, Harris. How are you?
Hi, Karina. How are you? I'm fine.
Okay.
What was that? Hi, Karina. I'm fine. What? Okay, continue.
I'm fine too. What are you doing?
Now I am in my English class. And you?
Oh, good. I'm in my English class too. How was your day today?
Fine. Today I did homework and I had my class, my virtual class, all the morning.
And what about your virtual classes?
Fine. Only that sometimes are boring and difficult. In my personal opinion, the mathematics is more difficult and virtual than presential class.
Okay.
Oh, I'm agree with you. I have a lot of classes with numbers, and it's so hard to me to learn because the teachers maybe don't explain, like when you are in personal in school, and it's hard.
And it's horrible when you can't to do a exercise.
Oh, yes.
Hey, I have a question. When you are in a virtual class, in this case, when you are in a mathematic or number class, and the teacher say, okay, students, let's do it, exercise number 5, for example. How can the teacher make sure that you are doing okay? So you send a picture or in your case, Kari, how's the dynamic when you are doing an exercise and it's related with numbers?
Okay.
So do you send the results or what?
You know that in the university is not the same like in the school. So
yeah,
if mm-hmm. in the school, if you don't give the homework, they call to your fathers or partners and mm-hmm. say that you are responsible and mm-hmm. make some pains to you. But in the university, if you want to learn, you learn. If you don't want, they don't care. So
stop. Yeah, can you please listen to Karina? And this is true. In the schools, your parents always pushing you. They are always pushing. Okay, study, do your homework, do your activities. At the university, it's totally complete yes. different 100%
by yourself.
Yes, it depends of you. It doesn't matter. Okay, I'm a teacher teaching at the university. O sea, supongo que yo estuve enseñar en la universidad. Yo no enseño en la U. I don't know why, but the teachers don't care if you do your homeworks, if you present
pay attention,
if you pay attention in class. No, they don't care.
If you
they
enter in it. The classes.
Yeah. Nati is missing. Oh, y la Nati faltó. I don't care. It's totally opposite with the school. Yes, Kari, continue, please.
Yes, they means like you know everything and you are there mm-hmm. because you want to be a professional.
Mm-hmm.
So they don't, how can I say exigir?
They punished. They, o sea, they exigen.
Mm-hmm. Okay, they punish you anything. So everything is by yourself there. So hey, when...
Yes, excuse me, continue please.
Okay, when I'm in class, the teachers just only question one time. If nobody respond, kids continue with the class, and if you learn, they don't care.
Okay, if you learn, okay. If you're not, okay.
Yes.
So, Karina, can you please explain to everyone what's the difference between a normal test to a parcial?
Okay. Now I think that in the time, it's the same. Because, I don't know if you are in the college now. I'm sorry, in the school now. But when I was in high school, the exam or the parciales, no sé cómo se dice en inglés.
It's the same, parcial.
Is some, how can I say, parecido? Similar. Because they give you the time, okay, you have 20 minutes to do your exam, and that's all. You have 20 items, and you have to respond. I don't know if...
Okay, and do we have questionnaires? At the university or not. For example, in the school, as a teacher, we say, okay, student, if you want, make a questionnaire related with page from page 5 to page 20. Make a questionnaire and I'm going to take the question from that page.
No, no,
is it the same at the university?
No.
Right?
They just say you have to study or it's a surprise exam or a quiz.
Yeah.
And that's all. You have to live or alive by yourself. It's okay. So different.
It's
and
totally
the
impression yeah.
of the homeworks, the classes mm-hmm. is so different to the school and the high school.
Yeah. Yeah. Nice opinion. Thank you, Kari. Nice opinion. Thank you, Harry. Ahí ya no te dejamos hablar, hijo, que me emocioné con el tema. Miren, para los futuros que van a los que quieren estudiar en la universidad, bueno, en mi opinión personal, a mí me gustó más la U que el colegio. Quizás porque en la U usted estudia lo que ya le gusta. Y me gustó también porque son menos horas de estudio. Al menos en mi carrera, yo jamás recuerdo que yo me haya desvelado estudiando. Yo era de las personas que utilizaba todo el día, toda la tarde, pero yo jamás me andaba acostando a las 3 de la mañana. No sé, gracias a Dios nunca, no es que fui la que inteligente. Pero no, yo creo que cada quien se organiza. Entonces, yo sí, preferí eso, pero una de las desventajas es esa, que en la universidad los maestros no te andan diciendo, mire hijo, ¿y por qué no entrego esto? Como en un colegio que yo conozco, que le dan 3 oportunidades, base 10, base 8 y base 6, en la universidad no es así. Ok, me encantó esa opinión. So, let's continue with the question. How do you see yourself in 5 years? Let's see, I have some examples. Example number 1. I see myself. Voy a comenzar con Belén por el compromiso que me dijiste, hija. I see myself traveling around the world. Teacher, in my opinion, wow. I hope to travel in 5 years more. I hope to travel to my favorite country. Example number 2. Permítame solo ingreso a Dani. Ahí está. Teacher, I see myself learning a new language. Besides English, besides Spanish, I see myself learning French, learning Japanese, learning Russian, etc. Teacher, in my case, teacher, no. I see myself getting married because now I have a boyfriend, teacher. Now I have a girlfriend and I am falling in love, teacher, with her. Well, I'm falling in love with him. So I see myself getting married, teacher. Teacher, in my opinion, I see myself getting a new house. Specifically, I would like to have a house in San Salvador City, or I would like to have a house in Apaneca City. Well, I see myself getting a house. In my case, teacher, I see myself getting a better salary. Now I'm working, but I hope in 5 years or less, or menos, in 5 years or less, I see myself getting a better salary, teacher, because I need it. Teacher, my opinion, I see myself visiting my favorite country. My favorite country is, let's see, Brazil. I would like to visit Brazil because I really love to dance bachata and, se me olvidó la, I am samba. Teacher, I see myself getting a baby. En el caso de las mujeres, ¿verdad? Los hombres no pueden, en este caso, getting a baby. So, teacher, I see myself getting a baby. I see myself in 5 years getting pregnant, teacher. Or in the case of the boys, teacher, I see myself to begin a father in the future. And the last one, teacher, in my opinion, talking about professional way, I see myself finishing my career. Now I'm studying high school and I see myself in 5 years finishing my career. Okay, Belen, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, so how do you see yourself in 5 years, Belen?
Well, I see myself studying in the university and working part-time.
Okay, thank you. Next, volunteer.
You, Nati.
Me.
Okay, Nati 1, Sophie 2, Franklin 3. Okay, Nati, go.
When I think in myself in 5 years, I think in many things, but now I can say I see myself with a nice job, with a great position in a company, and put all my focus and my attention in my work, in my grown up, in the grown up in that company. And maybe that's it I can say about it.
Okay, nice. Thank you. Yes, Sophie.
Okay, I see myself speaking 4 languages. I see myself finishing my career. And I see myself get a home and a car.
Getting a home and a car. Okay, nice. Thank you, Franklin.
I see myself traveling mechanic career. And I see myself, I have my car, for example.
Having a car. Okay, thank you. Who's missing? Volunteer?
Me.
John. Okay.
Vale 1, Danny number 2.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I see myself speaking English much better. And I see myself maybe could be a study, a career, and that could be doctorate. Oh, I see myself with, well, getting my new house and helping my parents.
And helping my parents. Excellent. Thank you. Yes, Danny.
Okay, I see myself living in another country. I see myself finish my career. I see myself marrying my real love. No, I'm joking. I'm just joking.
Okay.
That's it.
Okay, nice. Thank you. Yes, who's missing? Kari?
Me. Okay, having myself in 5 years, I will like to finishing my career, getting a very good job. And studying. I don't like to stop studying. Maybe that's helped me to get a more salary, I think. I don't know.
Okay. Hey, that can be a good question. What does it mean to have a good job? ¿Qué podría significar decir, okay, tener un buen trabajo? Maybe it's similar to get a good position in the work, to get a good salary. What does it mean to have a good job, students? Ya voy contigo, Jai. Me. Ajá, yes, Cari. ¿Qué pasó?
Mi perrito, lo siento. Okay.
What does it mean
that's
to have a good job?
That you are doing something that you love to do, you want to do.
Number one. Yes.
Second, you are, how can I say, ganando.
Earn. Como de dinero, es dinero, earn. Se escribe E-A-R-N, ganar. Earn. Earn money.
Okay. You are earning money enough to live, not like
luxury life, but
yes,
a normal life.
A normal life. And
normal economy.
Yes, and don't be a job like you get problems, maybe because now it's so common that el acoso y todo eso.
The harassment.
Yes.
Sexual harassment.
Yes, or que le ponen como más trabajo, no sé.
Okay, to have more work.
More work, yes. That's like, for me.
Fíjense que saben qué me está pasando últimamente, que sé cómo se dice en inglés y no me acuerdo cómo se dice en español. Lo de las maquilas les iba a decir. Okay, before to continue, another opinion. What does it mean to have a good job? Any opinion? 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, I'm going to finish by myself and then I'm going to go with Harris. Well, in my opinion, to have a good job is, number one, to work in a company or to work in a professional way, but that makes you happy any moment. Reason number two or option two can be to get a good salary because it's necessary, not to live it with a very extravagant or luxury life, but you need to have a normal life according to the a normal economy. And reason number three, to have a good job, it means like you can enjoy whatever you want to do in your job. Harris, in your opinion, how do you see yourself in 5 years?
In 5 years, I see myself finish the high school. Also, I see myself iniciando, ¿cómo se diría?
Beginning
the university. I see myself visiting my favorite country.
And visiting your favorite country. So, nobody's missing? 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, let's continue. Tell me about your weaknesses. Dime acerca de tus debilidades. Todos tenemos aquí debilidades. Ahora bien, I'm going to give you my example. Okay. In my case, one of my weaknesses is I focus too much on details. O sea, me enfoco demasiado en los detalles. I focus too much on details. Number two. I have serious problem saying no. Y eso sí es real para mí, fíjense. I remember when I was working in virtual classes, my bosses, well, I used to have 1, 2, 3 coordinators. And when they asked me to do a favor, I have serious problem to say no. I always say, okay, I will do it. most of the time I have many, many things to do. And I always say, okay, yes, I will help you. So I have serious problem saying no. Another reason, I don't like to ask for help all the time. Some people, when they are doing a new thing, for example, or when they are working in a new job, they don't like to ask for help all the time. They only say, okay, I can do it by myself. So it can be a weakness because nobody's perfect. Nobody's perfect, just God is perfect. So you are going to need help in the future. You don't know for what or why or when or where, but this can be a weakness. And this is a very common problem with people. They don't like to ask for help. Some people are perfectionists. A perfectionist person is a person that like to have all in the correct form. If they are going to do something, they like to do in a perfectionist way. So it can be a weakness because it's the same. Nobody's perfect. You are going to make mistakes. And the last one, and this has happened to me. Esto sí también me pasa a mí. I feel stress if people don't work at the same time like me. I remember when I was working in a virtual classes, I had a partner and I always had to say, okay, teacher, you have to do this one. In 1 hour, hey, Chepito, le vamos a poner al maestro. Chepito, do you do that thing? No, I didn't. And I feel stress, a lot of stress, because I feel stress if people don't work at the same time. And they can be a weakness because you need to share with different kind of people, different kind of persons. So you don't know what kind of person you are going to meet in the future, at the university or in your first job. So you need to feel, in this case, okay, I like to work like this, but I need to understand the other rest of the people because not all the time they are going to work at the same time like me. So my witness examples are this. So do we have any volunteer for question number two? I don't know if Belen, if you're ready, Belen?
Yes.
Okay, can you please tell us about your weaknesses?
One of my weaknesses is that I can't work with irresponsible person.
Uh-huh.
And I hate being late to place.
Yes, hey. I totally agree with you. I can work with irresponsible person. And that is a big weakness because I know me and I know my coworkers, and so I decide to do it by myself. Thank you, Belen. Volunteer?
Me, Sophia.
Okay, Yolanda. Sophie one, Nati two, Danny number three, go.
Okay, first, I can work with irresponsible people I hate, and I am perfectionist. I like everything to be perfect. I don't know why, but this is one weakness.
Okay, nice. Thank you, Nati. Tell us about your weakness, please.
About my weakness? Well, I'm so perfectionist, and sometimes when someone can't do the things like I want, I prefer do the things by myself.
Me too. I prefer to do it by myself. Miren, I remember I had a partner, his name is Norberto, and he was a good co-worker, but the problem is he works very slowly. when you are working in a private school, the principal say, okay, I need to do this. And you have to work in, you have to work in page, for example. And I always catch in this case to work with him, and I feel stressed because because he doesn't work at the same time. At that time, he doesn't work at the same time like me. So I'm totally agree with you. And sometimes it can be stressful. It can be having a stressful situation too. Okay, yeah. Thank you. Yes. Yeah, Nati?
A lot of stressful.
Yes, it's a lot of stressful. Okay, thank you. Dani, ready?
Yes.
Tell us about your weaknesses.
Okay, about work, my weaknesses maybe is I want all the stuff perfect. And also I get very distracted by anything. And about myself, mm-hmm. my weakness is that I'm worried about what other people think about me. And
really?
Yeah, I depend on the opinion of others.
Okay.
Yes.
And it depends on the person. Because for example,
yeah,
I respect my parents' opinion. Because you know your parents love you, right? But it's totally different with friends. Sometimes I don't care what my friends think about me, but and I respect my brother's opinions, Danny. I have two brothers. They are younger than me. One is 25 years old and the little one is 21. And I always listen to them because they say, for example, y yo no sé, fíjate que me pasa, y eso que son varones. When I'm looking for a new blouse, I don't ask to my mom. I always ask to my little brother. And I say, hey, Javier, how I look? ¿Cómo luzco? And he say, okay, it is okay. No, Gabriela, no. Mm-mm. Get another one. Mm-mm. No, I don't like it. So it depends on the person. For example, I don't care what my friend thinks about me, but I respect my family opinion. What about you, Danny? You respect your friend's opinion, your parents' opinion, or what?
I respect both because maybe I need an opinion about, I don't know, my best friend or something like that. And I respect. But when it's
mm-hmm.
with my family, for the clothes, I want the opinion for my mom, and if I like the clothes, but if she don't like it, I have a...
You don't buy it.
Yeah, but also maybe I buy it, but I don't have the emotion that I have antes.
Before?
The emotion that I have before.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yeah. I'm understood. Yeah. Okay.
And that's it.
That's it. Thank you. Thank you, Dani. Yes, who's missing?
Me.
Me. Okay, Franklin and Valeria, number two. Yes, Franklin, tell us about your weaknesses. Esto se va a poner interesante. Vamos a ver cuáles son las debilidades de Franklin. Yes, Franklin, go.
My weakness are the first. Is that hungry about nothing?
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
The second is I get bored fast.
I know, yes.
And I don't have, how do you say, paciencia?
Patience.
I don't have patience. And the other that I only like to spend at home. I don't like to go out.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah.
That's interesting. Hey, how old are you, Franklin? How old are you?
15.
15, my goodness. And you don't like to go out?
No.
Okay, that's strange because you are younger than me. And in my case, one of my my favorite things to do is to go out. It doesn't matter if I go to the park, but I like to go out. Well, especially on weekends. From Monday to Friday, I work a lot. I'm a workaholic person. But on weekends, I like to go out. And maybe another weakness talking about you is you can get disturbed at any time. Yo creo que también te ¿cómo que se dice? Disturbed. ¿Cómo se dice cuando alguien no pone atención rápido todo el tiempo?
Te desconcentras
rápido. In my personal opinion, Bea Franklin. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Mire,
okay, who's mire, missing, Harry?
Antes de todo, con eso que quieren hacer al final, yo no sé si voy a ir.
No, ya le voy a decir a tu hermana que sí te lleve. Mira, y no me acordaba de eso. Ya, bueno, después vamos a hablar de eso. Yes, Haris, are you ready? Yo creo que se me durmió Haris. Ah, no, Valeria, yes, Valeria, go, okay. Please. I'm so sorry.
Okay, I can stay or I think I can stay with disorganized people.
And disorganizing people.
Disorganizing people, and well, in my opinion, I like to do everything in order and finish at the time. And well, two is stress me out when the people yell too much. I hate this.
okay, that is okay.
It's all.
Okay, this all. Thank you so much. And the last one, Haris, ready?
Yes.
So tell us about your weakness and Karina, yes. Karina, okay, thank you. Haris one, Karina number two.
My weakness are I can't work with pressure.
Under pressure.
Under pressure, and now in my class I don't pay attention when I have a phone or a YouTube open in my computer.
But it happened with the English Academy or in your virtual classes in the morning?
My virtual classes, because I don't have ganas, ¿cómo se diría?
I don't want
to be there.
You don't want to. So, do you prefer presential classes, Haris? Virtual?
Virtual in any things, but I prefer the presential because I can see my friends and I don't have many stress.
Yeah, no, I know. Miren, I understand all the things that you say, because it's totally different virtual to the presential classes. And I'm very sure this is going to be a background. O sea, eso no va a trazar. This is going to be a background in our decade. I'm not afraid of schools. I'm afraid of university people. Because when you're studying in the school, okay, it is important, but not according to the university people. So imagine you are studying to be a doctor. It can be impossible to have virtual classes if you want to practice, or if you want to do a surgery, so I don't know what kind of things, but it's totally different. I'm afraid of that, because this decade is going to be a very, very bad situation in the future. Yes, another weakness that you have, Haris. Oh, just one? Your microphone is off.
Harry, ¿se me dormiste, hijo? No, ahí está todavía. Okay. So, did you finish, Harris, or not?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. My goodness, say please, teacher, I finished. Okay, thank you, Harris. And the last one, Karina.
Okay, one of my weakness is that maybe we are in a situation that you have to be quiet and be seriously. And that's mm-hmm. hard for me because I'm very dynamic. So mm-hmm. I think that this is a weakness. Maybe it's a weakness that I don't like to work in groups sometimes because I stress very much and very easy. So that's all.
Well, I think it's not a weakness. Because when you are working in groups, yes, sometimes it can be stressful. But in your case, it's not a weakness because you are, in this case, a responsible person. So it happens in the school, it happens in the university, it happens in jobs. So for me, it's not a weakness, Karina.
For me, 50 and 50 because in uh-huh. some places that you're working, they pay you to work in groups and maybe the characters or the feelings of the people is not like yours and that's hard yeah. to work.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, nice. Thank you. Nice. Nice opinion. Nobody's missing, right? 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, let's continue. Do you remember we were studying, vamos con la parte de la gramática, we were studying the linking words. Linking words in this case are words that connect with another sentences. For example, we are going to watch a new video, este es un nuevo video, relating this case with the topic. Can you please pay attention?
First time here, don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell so you will not miss any of our videos. Words have four main functions. 1. Contrast. 2. Cause. 3. Effect. 4. Time indicators. 1. Contrast. There are a lot of linking words that have different structures. 1. But, however. Form. Subject plus verb plus object plus but, however, plus a sentence that has an opposite meaning. Examples. John has a lot of money, but, however, he is not happy.
Observe, en este caso, este ejemplo.
John has a lot of money, but, however, he is not happy.
He is not happy. ¿Cuántas linking words tenemos acá, en esta oración? Two. We have two. We have but and however. Podemos utilizar dos linking words unidas. Claro que sí se puede. ¿Por qué? Porque en este caso dice, John has a lot of money. Pero, however, he's not happy. Sin embargo, él no está feliz. ¿Cómo podríamos hacer otro ejemplo utilizando but y however? ¿Y volunteer?
Dale, Sofi.
Okay, Sofi, vamos. Okay, Sofi.
I don't like study, but however, it's important.
I don't like to study, but however, is important. No me gusta estudiar, pero sin embargo es importante. Thank you, Nati.
She's going to the party, but however, she don't like the music.
She's going to the party, but however, she doesn't like the music. Yes?
Yes.
O sea, ella va a la fiesta, pero sin embargo, a ella no le gusta la música. ¿Alguien más que quiera un último ejemplo? 5, 4, 3, 2, continue.
Jane studies hard, however, she doesn't get high marks.
Jane studies hard, however, she doesn't get high marks. How many linking words do we have in this sentence?
One. Mm-hmm.
Only one, however. O sea, Jane estudió bastante, sin embargo, ella no tuvo una nota alta.
We use but to connect between two opposite adverbs. Example, she speaks quickly but clearly.
El but es uno de los connectors o linking words más comunes. Ella habla rápido, pero claro. O sea, de entender que se le entiende. Por ejemplo, I speak English, but I don't like it. Yo hablo inglés, pero no me gusta. Otro ejemplo con but, algún voluntario. Este está fácil, este linking word está fácil. Yes, volunteer. Five.
I love the music, but I can't sing.
I love the music, but I can't sing. O sea, yo amo la música, pero no puedo cantar. Another example. 5, 4, 3, 2. Nati, can you please choose one student?
Franklin.
Okay, Franklin, please. One example using but.
She doing weekly homework. Ay, no.
Mm-hmm. Ella hace las tareas rápido. She does.
But.
The homework quickly, but.
Not cleaning.
But.
No big. No quedan bien.
But it completed in incomplete, pero son están incompletas. Vaya, pensá en una que sí. Bye, Belén. Espero que todo te salga bien, hija. Yes, pensé en una, por favor, correcta. En lo que pensás en una, Valeria, dame un ejemplo utilizando but.
She likes to go to the party, but she can dance.
Can you please repeat it?
Okay. She likes to go to the party.
He likes to go to the party.
But she can't and dance.
Ahí es el contraste. Primero me decís he y después me decís she.
Oh.
A él le gusta ir a la fiesta, pero a ella no le gusta bailar. Bueno, sí, aplica. Supongamos que estamos hablando de dos personas. Y que a él le gusta bailar y a ella no, digamos. Ok, Franklin, your example.
Buy many things, but... he buy many things, but they are... You cell phone?
No, I don't understand the second part.
Así.
Pensé en una. Okay. Pensé en una bien. Okay, Dani, any example using but?
I like watching people drawing, but I can't draw.
Excellent. I like to watch people drawing.
People drawing.
But I can't draw.
Me gusta ver a las personas dibujar, pero yo no puedo. Okay, Franklin, your example, please. Thank you.
He watching a series in English, but he doesn't understand him.
He doesn't understand. Okay, thank you. Let's continue.
We use but to connect between two opposite adjectives. Examples. He is young but strong.
Look at these examples.
He is young but strong.
He is young but strong. O sea, a pesar que él es joven, pero es fuerte. Él es joven, pero fuerte.
She is old but fat.
Ella es anciana, pero rápida.
Two. However, nevertheless, yet. Examples. He is very poor. However, nevertheless, yet, he is very happy. He is short. However, nevertheless, yet, he plays basketball well.
He's short. Podemos ocupar however, nevertheless, or yet.
¿Qué significa nevertheless?
Los tres significan a pesar de, o sin embargo, o aún. Que aunque, o sea, a pesar que, o sin embargo que él es, o aunque él es pequeño, él puede jugar baloncesto muy bien. Podemos ocupar however, nevertheless, or yet.
Three. Although, though, even though, even if. Form. Although, though, even though, even if, plus subject, plus verb, plus adjective, adverb, a sentence has an opposite meaning. Example. Although Maya works hard, she has some free time to enjoy herself.
Although, aunque.
Four, despite, in spite of, regardless of. Forms. Despite, in spite of, regardless of, plus infinitive, plus ing, noun, a sentence with an opposite meaning. Examples. Despite having free time, he is always busy.
Despite, a pesar que, o a pesar de, having free time, he is always busy. A pesar que él tiene tiempo libre, él siempre está ocupado.
Regardless of having a car, he goes to work on foot. Despite, in spite of, regardless of, plus the fact that, plus a sentence with an opposite meaning.
Yes?
Guess regardless and in spite of.
Sin importar, regardless, sin importar que, o the fact, o en el hecho que, son connector. Miren, hay un montón. Pero ya este ya es un nivel, ya entrando a un nivel avanzado con ustedes. O sea, lo que yo quiero es que de ahora en adelante tratemos de meter un poco más los linking words al momento de que nosotros hablemos. Ahora bien, eso se les va a quedar conforme la práctica. O sea, no se les va a quedar en la primera, segunda clase. Eso se les va a quedar conforme la práctica. Entonces, en el caso de regardless, sin importar que, de fact, el hecho es que.
Examples. Despite the fact that the team plays hard, it always loses.
O sea, sin importar o sin el hecho que el equipo jugó fuerte, jugó duro, ellos siempre pierden.
In spite of the fact that our country has many resources, it is very poor. 5. However.
Sin embargo.
Form. However. However plus adjective, adverb, plus subject, plus verb. Subject plus verb plus an opposite adjective, adverb. Examples. However old my aunt is, she is energetic. However hard he studies, he doesn't get high marks. 6. As. Form. Adjective, adverb, plus.
¿Cómo así, teacher? ¿Que cómo? O sea, ¿cómo de pregunta? No. ¿Cómo? O sea, por ejemplo, yo digo, ¿como tú? Puede ser, like you, y en este caso, puedo decir, tan pronto como sea posible. As soon as possible.
As, plus subject, plus verb, subject, plus verb, plus an opposite adjective, adverb. Examples. Old as my aunt is, she is energetic. Quickly as he runs, he doesn't get the first prize. 7. Whatever.
Como sea.
Forms. Whatever plus noun plus subject plus verb subject plus verb plus an opposite adjective adverb. Examples. Whatever books he reads, he doesn't know much knowledge. Whatever reports she writes, she doesn't send most of them to the manager. Whatever plus subject plus verb, a sentence with an opposite meaing. Example. Whatever my son does, I will forgive him.
Whatever my son does, I will forgive him. Lo que sea que haga mi hijo, yo siempre lo voy a forgive.
Perdonar.
Siempre lo voy a perdonar. Eso lo vimos el día de ayer. No lo voy a volver a dormir. Teacher, qué aburrido, qué estresante, qué confuso es este tema. No es que sea aburrido, estresante o confuso. Lo que pasa es que como aquí ya vamos subiendo el nivel, ya usted tiene que empezar, en este caso, cuando hable de inglés, tratar de meter estas linking words. Solo me voy a detener en lo siguiente. ¿Alguna linking word que esté aquí, que usted me diga, teacher, qué significa? Porque no sé. Five, four.
Todas las que están concluidas, pero solo briefly, no sé cómo se pronuncia, sum up, to summarize.
In, to conclude, las, in short, briefly, to sum up, to summarize, in conclusion, se ocupan cuando, por ejemplo, nosotros decimos, in short, o sea, y en pequeño, o sea, dando mi opinión, ya pequeña, chiquita, ya al final. Briefly, brevemente, muy específicamente, quiero decir esto, briefly. To sum up, haciendo un resumen chiquitito, to sum up, to summarize, en resumen, in conclusion, y en conclusión. Yo quiero decir esto, bla, bla, bla. Another one.
Yo tengo, I have a, la que dice to express, frequency.
Frequency, esa, to express sequence, para expresar una secuencia, cuando decimos, ok, my favorite color is, first, el primero, first. To start with, iniciando con,
to start with my opinion, iniciando con mi opinión, then, y luego, then, after this, después de esto, after this, afterwards, después de todo, finally, lo que a veces me dicen ustedes a mí, finalmente, lastly, y por último. Podemos decir, o sea, cuando vayan ustedes a terminar de hablar algo, me pueden decir, después de after this, afterwards, finally, o lastly. Another opinion?
Sí, ¿qué significa E.G? And to give examples.
Lo mismo, for example, E.G. Ah, agregando otro ejemplo, E.G., agregando otro ejemplo, el que se me ha ido es este, IE. El que se me ha ido es IE. Yes. Es decir, este otro que está en abreviatura. Es decir, dicho, o sea que si yo quiero decir algo, solo digo IE. Yes, IE. Es decir, porque ya ustedes entonces está hablando un inglés como que hubiera nacido en Estados Unidos. O sea, ya no dice like this o finally o in my opinion, sino que dice teacher, IE, es decir, yes, this one, ¿verdad? IE, es decir, en EG es, y agregando otro ejemplo, EG, another opinion o another word, four, three, two, okay, let's continue. Conjunctions. Yo no les digo linking words, a mí me encanta decirles conjunctions. No los voy a topar con tanta información para que más o menos se les quede. Ya vieron ustedes que hay un montón de linking words, hay un montón de conjunctions. Aparte de las del video, también están estas. So, voy a pedir ayuda de todos ustedes, por favor. Vale, can you please help me to read despite?
Despite. Despite is used to introduce a fact that it is in sharp contrast with another fact. Example? Despite a hair fault, everybody likes him.
Despite, a pesar de. Thank you. Danny, provide.
Provide means if or only if. Example, they can listen to music provided they disturb nobody.
Provide, en vista que o en vista de, thank you, Franklin, unless.
Unless means except on the condition that you don't need to go unless you want to.
A no ser que, por ejemplo, tú no necesitas ir, a no ser que quieras, el unless, a no ser, you want to, a no ser que quieras. Thank you, Harris, since. Thank you, Harris, 5, 4, 3, okay, go.
Since I use my t-shirt red.
Yes, but the explanation since it used to, estás un youtuber. Since, the explanation, please, Harris. Aquí nos vamos a estar hasta que Harris nos conteste. Se me llegó la otra clase. Harris, ¿qué pasa contigo, hijo? Salite de YouTube un ratito. Sin.
No, no estoy ahí.
La explicación. Sin. Harris, está bien, hijo. 5, 4, 3. Okay, volunteer. No sé qué me le pasó a Harris. Volunteer. Okay, thank you, Franklin. Since
is used to show results, since I see you, I am better.
Since, desde,
since, desde. Thank you. Let's see who's Nati, can you please? So.
So is used to show result. Well, whoever says so is a liar.
And so, entonces, thank you. Who's next? Let me see. Kari, can you please if? No, no tengo a Kari aquí. Creo que tuvo problemas de inter. Yes, Sophie, thank you.
So is used to show if also.
If.
If.
Yeah.
If is used to show condition, let me know if you go to the school.
If significa si. Déjame saber si vas a ir a la escuela. Thank you, Valeria. Yet.
Yet show contrast on joins opposite. We haven't finished eating the watermelon yet.
Yet, aún, significa aún. O sea, no hemos terminado de comer la sandía aún. En negativo, aún no. Not yet. Thank you. Nati, after.
After, tell us about order sequence. I can pass after the green light is on.
Thank you. After, después. Thank you, Dani, because.
Because it's used to show reason. She usually eats at home because she likes cooking.
Recuerde que el because es por qué, pero cuando vamos a dar una explicación. Thank you. Can you please, Franklin, also.
Also, mm-hmm. It's used to show to opposite.
Statement.
¿Cómo se dice?
Also,
he speaks seldom. He says meaningful
words. Thank you. Also, aunque, thank you, Nati. Whereas
is used to show contrast. She's very funny, whereas he is boring.
Whereas, mientras que. Thank you. Let's see. Sophie, but.
But it used to join the ideas that are opposites. I am very hungry, but the fruit is empty.
But, pero, thank you, Nati, besides.
Besides, mean in addition to, also. It is a preposition. She speaks three languages besides Spanish.
Además de. Thank you, Dani. Unlike.
Unlike means different from, not similar to. Jack is completely unlike his father.
A diferencia de. Y termino con therefore. Therefore, it used to show the result. Effort on an action. She came first, therefore she got a good seat. Por lo tanto. Ok, chicos, me quedo hasta acá. El día de mañana voy
pregunta.
A... Yes, dígame.
Va a enviar esta imagen al grupo.
Espérame, le voy a tomar foto ahorita. Espérame. Ay. Para mandárselos ahí. Espérame. Vamos a ver. Level 6. Y ya le voy a mandar la otra también porque les tengo esta también. Pero esa la vamos a ver mañana para no cansarlos. Y si no van a sentir muy pesada la clase porque no es que sea confuso, pero sí es de práctica nada más. Ahí les mandé las imágenes, señores. Pasen una feliz noche. Nos vemos el día de mañana siempre a las 5 de la tarde. Bye. Bye, people.
Bye, guys.